How is it going, ladies and gentlemen? This is the Wolf Around, and it's great to see you here. In this video, I'll show you how to migrate your Unreal Engine projects to version 5.7. It has been 1 week since the Unreal Engine 5.7 was released. This new version requires the latest Visual Studio's built environment, and migrating to it is not as straightforward process as it used to be. Throughout this video, I'll show you every step and highlight potential errors you might encounter. Subscribe to the channel, join the pack, you are always welcome here. Without further ado, let's get started. As you can see, Unreal Engine 5.7 is available on the Epic Games Launcher. But before installing it, we need to install Visual Studio 2026. You must install Visual Studio 2026 even if you use another code editor or IDE. Because the essential tools required to compile an Unreal Engine 5.7 project will be installed along with it. Go to the official website and download the installer. I'll share the link in the video description. The installer will install a software called Visual Studio Installer, which will then set up the new build environment along with Visual Studio 2026. When it is launched, it will offer to extract some features if the older version, the Visual Studio 2022, is already installed. If you see this window, just choose Select Workloads and Components manually and click Next button. Now you are seeing Workloads window. Select these three workloads: .NET Desktop Development, Desktop Development with C++, Game Development with C++. Before clicking Install button, switch Individual Components tab and choose .NET 8.0 Runtime Long-Term Support option. This .NET version is required by the Unreal Build tool, as the date I'm recording this video. The Unreal Build tool is a component that is installed along with the Unreal Engine, and it requires exactly the .NET version 8.0. The required .NET version may change in the future. At the end of this video, I'll show you how to check out the required version. Now click Install button and wait for the download and installation to complete. Visual Studio 2026 is now installed. Head back to the Epic Games Launcher and start installing Unreal Engine 5.7. It will show you the installation path and folder. Click Options button and enable Editor Symbols for debugging. This is optional but recommended if you want to debug your C++ code effectively. I'm mentioning it as a helpful tip. Click Apply button and turn back to previous menu. I'll also customize my installation folder. Make a note of your installation folder. We'll visit it at the end of the video. Click Install button to start the download and installation. Once the installation is complete, I'll click Launch button to make sure engine starts without issues. You can skip this step. It's just a quick verification. Now I've closed all windows and opened the folder containing the project I want to migrate to Unreal Engine 5.7. Before proceeding, locate the Epic Games Launcher icon in your system tray and exit it completely. Then relaunch it. If you see a warning that says Project Files Not Associated, click the Fix Now button. Now we can begin the migration. Right-click the file that ends with New Project. Click Show More Options and switch Unreal Engine version. From this menu, choose 5.7. and click OK button. This will generate project files. Once complete, navigate to source folder and open the files that end with target.cs in a text editor. Also open the file that ends with uproject in a text editor. First check the engine association value in the uproject file. It has to be 5.7. Next, check the build settings version and engine include order version fields in both of the target.cs files. If they don't match what's shown on the screen right now, you'll need to edit them manually. For the Unreal Engine 5.7, update the build settings version to V6 and engine include order version to engine 5.7. Now I'll delete all generated files and folders from the previous engine switch process and reapply the same process again. Now it's time to compile your project. Either double-click the uproject file and wait for the completion, or you can open the SLM file in the Visual Studio 2026 and compile your project in it. Let's apply both of ways in this video. First, I'll double-click the uproject file. When you double-click it, it will tell you to build the project. Click Yes button. Since this is the first completion after migration, it will take a lot of time. I have sped it up in the video editing. If this process fails, it likely means there is a syntax error in your C++ code. To fix it, open the SLM file in your preferred IDE. After successful completion, Unreal Engine will pre-compile its shaders. Wait for that to finish. When the Unreal Engine editor opens, you can go to Help from top menu and click About Unreal Engine Editor to check out the version. Now let's compile the project in the IDE. If you are using Visual Studio, make sure it's the latest version of 2026. I'll set Visual Studio 2026 as the default program for SLM files, and open it. Now the project has opened in the IDE, and I want to show you an Unreal Engine source file called target-rules.cs. Whenever you need to edit target.cs files to migrate your project, you can check out target-rules.cs file. It contains all the version numbers. You can find this file in the following path inside your game engine installation directory. Lastly, I'll click the build button in the IDE and wait for completion to complete. Once done, the Unreal Editor will launch again. To determine which .NET version the Unreal build tool requires, navigate to your engine installation folder and follow this directory path. Open the Unreal build tool C# project file and check the version number inside the target framework tag. If this version is not installed, Open the Visual Studio Installer and install it. I'm a software engineer specializing in computer graphics, game development, and cross-platform C++ development, and I look forward to sharing more insights with you. Stay tuned, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.